Just to get an example and to reconsider what we previously saw in terms of our GEO satellite, so we saw we received less than 1 picowatt, but now let's see if this is actually good communication. It seems like very little power, but will we actually work? Will we actually be able to transmit and receive properly? Suppose that we have an effective system temperature of 300 Kelvin, so this is a parameter of the whole system. We can typically give an estimate of it. This translates to GR over TS, so gain of the receiver over system temperature, to be equal to 35, which was the original gain of the receiver, minus 10 logarithm 10 of 300, so minus the temperature in dBs, and this gives us about 10.2 dB Kelvin. Now, if we go back to our formula, we already had the power computed, but let's just, again, use all the terms to see where everything comes from. Again, we have the same free space losses because the satellite is again in geosynchronous orbit, roughly 36,000 kilometers above the surface. We have the same power of transmission, so the 700 watts, which converted to dB watts are 28.5. And what we get, if we suppose 100 kilobit transmission rate, so 100 kilobits per second, this corresponds to 10 logarithm 10 of 10 to the power 5, it's 50 in terms of dB notation. So our transmission rate is 50 dB in terms of this Friis formula. And computing EB over N0 finally with all of these terms, we get 20, which is the gain of the transmitting antenna, plus 28.5, which was actually the power of transmission, so those 700 watts which we had, plus 10.2, which is now the gain of the receiver divided by this effective system temperature, minus 203.5, which are the free space losses, minus 5, which were the additional losses. So far it looks almost the same as our previous example. But now we add 228.5, which is Boltzmann's constant in the denominator. We also subtract 50 more for R, the transmission rate in the denominator. And the final result which we get is actually close to 29 dBs. So we get a result for EB over N0, which is very close to almost 30 dBs. And if we look at the graph of all of the different modulation schemes, we can see that, in fact, this is very, very, very much to the right on the x-axis. And so for sure, whatever type of modulation we're using out of these which are listed here, we're going to have very small bit error rate. So for all of these, our value of EB over N0 corresponds to 1 in 1,000,000,000 bits wrong or something like this. So what we compute is actually that we would have very nice communication with these values of temperature and the gains and the distance and so on. So this teaches us something very important. It is not, again, it's not important what our absolute power is. The only thing that matters is what our channel-to-noise ratio is, or in terms of bit error rate, what our energy per bit per unit spectral density is, EB over N0. So let's just do a very quick summary of the link budget procedure. So how do you do the link budget? How do you compute the link budget? And how do you know if your communication is good enough? And how do you know if you need to improve anything and how to improve it? So it's the whole thing is sort of an iterative procedure. So you do it iteration by iteration. Now, first, you need to evaluate the power of transmission. So you may know very accurately how much it is, but you should estimate at least or measure it somehow. What is the transmitting power? So P subscript T. Then you should evaluate the gain of the antenna in the respective direction in which you're going to transmit. So typically, if we're talking about an aperture antenna and in space communications, you're going to always transmit or receive in the highest directive gain direction. So you're going to have really the gain by its definition as being the highest power of the directive gain times the losses. But in any case, it may happen that you don't have very good accuracy at pointing. You may have to consider some losses due to that. So you should evaluate what the transmitting antenna gain is. So you should very accurately evaluate on the directive plot exactly what the gain is. you should estimate the space losses. So this is actually something which may not be very straightforward. It will depend on the orbit, it will depend on how eccentric it is. So if you have a satellite in a very eccentric orbit, it may turn out that in some points of the orbit it will be just a few hundred kilometers above you, and in other times it will be a few thousand kilometers. So you may have a factor of 10 in the distance, which is a lot. So we know that 10 times further means 100 times less power. So you should really evaluate, and you should put some range on this free space loss depending on how far the satellite is at the time of communication. The next thing to do, very straightforwardly, is to estimate any additional losses. So you should estimate the atmospheric losses depending on the season. So there are very nice statistical plots which we saw. So depending on the season, depending on the geographical region, you should really estimate the losses due to the atmosphere, and perhaps also put some extra just to be pessimistic, if you like. The next thing to do is estimate the total system temperature. So you should estimate the total amount of noise. This may not be very easy, this may be a rather crude estimation, but you should estimate the total system temperature. And if you have a very nice measurement, which is typically the case of the receiver antenna gain, you can immediately compute the GR over TS quantity. So the gain of the receiver divided by the system temperature. So if you can compute this in decibels, this is another part of the link budget equation which you have already. And so at this point, if you know what rate you want to transmit at, you can already calculate the EB over N0. So you have all of the different quantities which you need. You have the free space losses, we have the additional losses, you have the gains of both antennas in the case of the transmit antenna, simply the gain in the case of the receive antenna, you have GR over TS, so gain divided by temperature, you have the power of transmission, and all of these things, they allow you to compute the EB over N0. So now you can actually compute what is your bit error rate, because typically you will know what your modulation is. So in this case, you might actually want to consider what types of modulation you should use. There may be, of course, implementation problems for that, but at this point, if you know your modulation type, you can actually calculate your bit error rate. And the last thing which you can do is actually calculate the margin. So you can calculate your bit error rate, and you can calculate what is the required bit error rate. So typically you're going to have some requirements of the system, and you can compare what is the desired EB over N0 for that required bit error rate. And if you have this, so if you have the required EB over N0 and you have your EB over N0 from those estimates and from those measurements of your system, you can immediately compare them. And if there is a difference and it's positive, so if your EB over N0 is better, it's larger than the desired, then everything is great. So you can communicate with no problems, you're going to have less errors than your requirements say. But if the margin is negative, so if this quantity EB over N0 minus EB over N0 desired, if it's negative, then you're not going to be good enough. So your communication system is not going to give you the desired bit error rate. It's going to be higher. So in this case, what you can do, and this is the last step of the iterative algorithm, is to modify one of the different things. So for example, if the satellite is not yet in orbit, you may be able to change its antenna. Maybe you can increase the power to it, so you can modify it either GT or PT. Maybe you can get a larger antenna on the ground. Maybe you can somehow reduce the effective noise temperature by introducing some shielding from noises. Depends. Maybe you can pick a different modulation scheme. So all of these things, all of these quantities, you can modify them in such a way that you can reach the desired bit error rate. And if you can't do it with one parameter, maybe you can try something else. But at this point, this whole thing is just an iterative procedure. And so you know what you have, and you start going through it again and again and trying to modify things in such a way as to get what you need. And once you get a positive margin, everything is good. So you're sure that your communication system is good enough and you can have good enough bit error rate. Now, one last word of advice is that in general, there will always be implementation losses. So, okay, in theory, maybe your antenna will have a perfect 35 dBi gain, but in practice, maybe the way it is built, the implementation of everything itself, it may actually lead to additional losses. So typically, you should probably add a few dBs just for implementation losses depending on the quality of the whole system in general. So there it is. So you can now compute the link budget, and having all of these quantities, you can now tell how good a communication system is.